Stage 3 tax cuts for the nation's highest earners are back in the headlines, at least in part this morning. According to the Australian Financial Review, the Coalition is looking to fund its promised tax cuts for aspirational voters from scrapping a raft of Labor policies. That's how it will be funded if it wins the next election. Joining us live now, the Chief Investment Officer at the Motley Fool, Scott Phillips. Scott, good morning to you. So there had always been a plan for this to try and keep that going for those highest earners that were docked a couple of grand from the current government. So they're pushing through with this with some new detail this morning. What are your thoughts on it?
Pete, good morning. Mate, economically, the first thing I will say is that if this does go ahead as planned, at the very least, they're going to do it out of spending cuts rather than simply adding it to the national credit card. You and I have talked many, many times about Stage 3, and I have been on record under the previous government and the current one saying that funding tax cuts by making the national debt worse is a terrible way to set policy. This time around, it does seem like the Coalition plans to go to the next election, if those reports are true, with spending cuts that would pay for the tax cuts, which is exactly what you should do if you're looking for it. Talking about production credits, talking about fringe benefits tax on EVs, potentially, talking about other spending programs being rolled back to make money available. And they're talking about increasing the threshold, the 37-cent tax bracket, up from $135,000. Now, we don't yet know what to. This is clearly a pitch for aspirational voters, and the politics is someone else's domain. Economically, I think this is exactly, if you're going to do it, exactly the right way to do it, which is finding those spending cuts. Okay. I've got to say, I think some of these policies in particular are worth getting rid of. The Future Made in Australia stuff, I think, is going to end up being a complete boondoggle. It is simply kind of government picking winners, and I'm not a fan. Also, FBT on EVs. EVs, I think, are now broadly accepted enough. There are enough producers out there, enough brands.
Right.
Yes, we want people to move away from, you know, polluting engines, but I don't think the FBTA exemption is necessary anymore. So if you're going to go at it, I think they're probably doing it the right way in terms of making those spending cuts.
Okay.
And also, the areas they're looking for it look pretty good.
So the Australians, it's talking about this $100 billion that the opposition has found that it would cut down the debt. I mean, does that all sound reasonable from where all that's come from this morning? Sounds like you might agree with it.
I think the $100 billion is going to be hard to find, mate, really honestly. I think both electorally and financially, very, very difficult to find that much money. Just back to the Fin for 1 second, there's an insider apparently quoted saying trying to find $30 billion would be almost impossible without blocking supply. So go to $100 billion back in the Oz's article. I think it's probably unlikely, mate. The other thing too, by the way, very few oppositions can resist the urge to spend more coming into an election.
Yeah.
So is there a net reduction of $100 billion? I would absolutely bet against it. Do I think that this is the right approach? Absolutely. The budget is not in structural balance. It must be if we are to proceed economically in any meaningful, responsible fashion. This is, you know, we're putting more and more on the credit card. So, yeah, getting back to structural balance is really important. If the opposition are genuinely going to commit to doing that and finding tax increases or spending cuts or both, I think that'd be a very, very good thing for the nation's finances.
All right, Scott Phillips, good to chat as always. We'll see you soon.